Dear students, in this lecture video, we studied about the one of the type of the power reactors, which is known as gas-cooled reactors. The abbreviation is GCR. Now we studied about the introduction to gas-cooled reactors. The gas-cooled reactors is nothing but this type of reactors, the gas is used as a coolant. Gas is used as a coolant in place of water. Either carbon dioxide or helium gas is used as a coolant in the gas cooled reactor. That's why this reactor called as the gas cooled reactors. This is the one of the type of power reactors. Graphite is used as a moderator. What is the advantages of this gas cooled reactors using gas as a coolant? The first advantage is safe, easy to handle. It can be heated up to any temperature without change of phase at any pressure. That's why gas is used as a coolant in the gas cooled reactors. The uranium dioxide is used as a fuel in the gas cooled reactors. So coolant is gas, that is carbon dioxide or helium. Moderator is graphite. Fuel is uranium dioxide. This is the important key points. Keep it in your mind. The next, the concrete sealed cover up the core, that is reactor core. Reactor core is the one of the component of the nuclear reactor, which is used to avoid the radiation leak. For that purpose only we are using the concrete shield. That is nothing but the biological shield we already studied in the nuclear reactor components lecture videos. All the essential components are contained in the pressure vessel. This is also one of the component of the nuclear reactor. There are 4 bars of the uranium fuel elements wrapped by the graphite moderators with a number of charge tubes sticking into them in order to load few elements. The continuation of gas cooled reactors is 2 ducts run out of the reactor to form the gas duct circle with the heat exchanger. So in gas cooled reactors, heat exchanger is necessary, that is required. The gas is circulated in the gas cooled reactor through reactor core, and the heat exchanger, that is blower or the gas compressor, is used as a heat exchanger. The steam pressure is around 150 atmosphere. The temperature is around 550 degrees centigrade. The tube in the heat exchanger through which the water is circulated, which should have fins of their surface. Finally, to improve the rate of the heat transfer in the gas cooled reactors. So now you see the circuit diagram. This is the gas cooled reactors. The gas cooled reactor consists of water. This is the charge tube. Charge tube means, so you see the outer side, that is the radiation shielding. That means the rectangle green, that is the radiation shielding. Pressure vessel inside, that the oval shape green line is nothing but the pressure vessel. And then the gray color rectangular vertical line is called as a graphite moderator. In the graphite moderator, the fuel rod is there, which the color is the rectangle orange color, that is the vertical line. and then the block color vertical line is nothing but the control rods. So this is the charge tubes. This is the hot gas ducts path. This is the steam outlet. This is the water inlet. This is the water circulating pump. This is the gas circulating pump. So this is the gas, cool gas duct. This is the heat exchanger. This is the components. Now what is the procedure? You see in the nuclear reactor, gas, okay, gas, that is the, from the heat exchanger, gas comes to nuclear reactor. At the same time, the water comes to heat exchanger. Okay, again both are goes to nuclear reactor, which is here already fuel is there, uranium and all. And then moderator is graphite. And then coolant is here water. Gas is the coolant. Graphite is the moderator. In this case, the hot gas produced again is comes to heat exchanger. It converted into steam. This steam goes to turbine. This steam only is used to drive the turbine. The turbine coupled with the generator. The turbine converts steam energy into mechanical energy. This mechanical energy drives the generator. Now the generator generates electricity. So this is the working function of gas cooled reactors. Students, I hope from this figure you clearly understand. That is, with the help of this diagram, you clearly understood the working operation of the gas cooled reactors and then what are the components used in the gas cooled reactors. Now, what is the advantages of gas-cooled reactors? Here, there is no corrosion problems. Water and gas is used. That's why there is no corrosion problem. It is greater safety because gas is used as a coolant instead of water. And then the gas are easy to handle also and then safe also. That's why greater safety. The contamination problems are moderate. That means the disposal of radioactive material. And then these reactors are operated at a high temperature. The gases are pressurized easily. The graphite, which is used as a moderator, which remains stable at a high temperature. Therefore, the radiation problems are minimum in the gas-cooled reactors. These are the advantages or the key points, important technical points I highlighted in the PPT. The student, that point compulsory have to write in the examination. Okay. Then, disadvantages of gas-cooled reactors. The first disadvantage, large size of reactors, because the natural fuel and the graphite used as a moderator, it extremely consume low power density and then low steam pressure and temperature. That means the steam pressure and temperature is low and then the fuel is operated at high temperatures. Suppose the helium is used as a coolant in the gas cooled reactors, means what happened? The leakage of this helium gas is a major problem. That means the disposal of this contamination is a major problem for us. The gases have a low heat transfer coefficient. It requires large heat exchangers. The large amount of the fuel loading is required for gas cooled reactor. This is the one of the demerits of gas cooled reactors. And then more power is needed for coolant circulation compared to water cooled reactors. இந்த வாட்டர் கூல்டு ரியாக்டர்ஸ் வாட்டர் இஸ் யூஸ்ட் ஆஸ் அ கூலண்ட் பட் இந்த கேஸ் கூல்டு ரியாக்டர்ஸ் த கேஸ் இஸ் யூஸ்ட் ஆஸ் அ கூலண்ட் ஸோ தெர்ஃபோர் இஃப் வி ஆர் யூஸ்டு கேஸ் ஆஸ் அ கூலண்ட் தென் த மோர் பவர் இஸ் நீடட் கம்பேர்டு டு வாட்டர் கூலண்ட் ரியாக்டர்ஸ் Dear students, I hope that in this lecture video, you clearly understood the concept of working operation of the gas-cooled reactors, circuit diagram, advantages, disadvantages of gas-cooled reactors. Under this topic, how the question will come with a neat diagram or neat sketch, explain the working operation of the gas-cooled reactors. The minimum mark is 6, the maximum mark is 8. Thank you, student, for watching this video.